Today we'll complete part 3 of first unit, that is some basic concept of chemistry, class 11, science. The topic we are going to cover today is significant figures and rounding of the significant figures. So, what is the basic about significant figure? There is an uncertainty in experimental or calculated value if you ignore the significant figure. Significant figures are meaningful digit which are known with the certainty, and to express any number or to find the significant figures for a given number, we have to follow some rules. Okay, so we'll see what are the rules we have to follow for significant figures. So the first rule is all the non-zero digits are significant. Okay, so if you are getting any non-zero digit, for example, here you are getting 328.2. See, there is no zero in the given number. So how many significant figures are there? There are 4 significant figures. Okay, so that is the first rule. Next rule is zeros preceding to first non-zero digit are not significant. So on the left hand side of a non-zero digit, if you are getting zero, then those zeros are not significant. For example, here you can see 0.03. okay, 3 is your significant number, but the preceding zeros are not significant. So for this number, how many significant figures are there? There is only 1 significant figure. Okay, same way here, how many are there? 5, 2 is significant and preceding zeros are non-significant. So total significant figure for this 0.0052 is 2. Third point, zeros between 2 non-zero digits are significant. Okay, on left and right, if you are getting non-zero digit, and in between if you are getting any number of 0, then that 0 also becomes significant. For example, 2.005. 2 is non-zero digit, so significant. 5 is also significant. So in between, these 2 zeros are also becoming significant. Okay, so here how many significant figures are there? Here you are getting 4 significant figures. You have to remember all these rules. Next, zeros at the end or right of a number are significant provided they are on the right side of a decimal point. So actually what happened, on the right hand side, if you are getting 0, okay, that means if you are getting the ending 0 or terminal zeros, then these are not significant, but the right hand side zeros will become significant if there is any decimal point. So if decimal point is there, then only the terminal zeros are significant, otherwise not. So this is very confusing point, remember it carefully. Okay, zeros at the end or the right of a number is significant if decimal point is present. Okay, so this is some rule. For example, 200 gram has 3 significant figures, but if otherwise the zeros are non-significant. For example, 100 have only 1 significant figures. So if you are just given a number, then these zeros are not significant. But if you are giving with a unit, particular unit, if it is present or if decimal is there, then they become significant. Exact numbers have an infinite number of significant figures. Okay, for example, if you are given 2 balls, this 2 ball you can present as 2.000. Then see, decimal point if it is there, then all the 0 become significant. You may put as many 0 as you want. So it is an infinite significant figure. Same as 20x, 20 you can present as 20.000. So it also become a infinite significant figures. So exact numbers if you are given, then they are infinite significant figures. So these are some rule about a significant figures. Not very tough, but just the thing you have to remember all the rules. Okay, now we'll see addition and subtraction including your decimal point. These are basic mathematics, all of you know this. Just the thing you have, we are revising the calculations. Okay, now one example we'll take where we have chosen addition of decimal point. So you are given 12.11, 18.0, 1.012. So if you sum up, the value will come out as 31.122. right, now When you will write the answer, how will you write? See, the process is, you are adding this 3, okay, this, this and this. In this 3 number, the smallest number is this 18.0. Here, how many decimal places there? There is, after decimal, only one position is there. Okay, this is the smallest number. Okay, here the smallest decimal point is there. Here, only one position after decimal, here 2, here 3 place, like that. So, you will choose the smallest decimal position and based on this, you will write your number. So, here after decimal point, one position. So, in the answer also, you have to choose up to only one position. That means your answer will be 31.1. That's all. Okay. This 22, you have to ignore. So, see here. The result cannot have more digit to the right of the decimal point than either of the original numbers. So, this is what happened. One digit after the decimal point. Therefore, the result will be 31.1. One digit after the decimal point. In the answer also, same thing will happen. This is true for addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. Same way, here also the same rule will be followed. So, if you multiply 2.5 into 1.25, the values will come out as 3.125. Here, decimal after decimal, the smallest point is one place. So, your answer will be up to 3.1. This 25 you have to ignore. Okay, same way it will go for the division. Okay, now see the problem. How many significant figures are present in the following? The first problem you see. What is given here? 0.0025. What you know? The rule say that the left hand side zeros or the preceding zeros are non-significant. So here non-zero digits are 2 and 5. Okay, all the zeros are on the left hand side. So how many significant figures are there? There are only 2 significant figures. Then second point. 0 between 2 non-significant figures are significant. So, here how many significant figures you are getting? Here you are getting 3. Same way, here how many it will be? Here it will be, the zeros are in between. So, you will be getting 4 significant figures. Here you see, you are not getting any decimal point, okay? These 3 zeros are terminal zeros. Terminal zeros are non-significant if decimal point is absent, okay? Here do mark it, it is comma, not a point, okay, it's not a decimal point. So here how many significant figure? 3. Then in this number you are getting terminal zeros with decimal points, so all become significant. How many significant figures you are getting here? 4. Here in between two non-zero digit you are getting 0, so they are significant. So here the number is, number of significant figure is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So here it will be 5. Okay, like that. Some more example you will try yourself. Next we'll see the rounding of the numbers. Now rounding off means what? You will cut short the number. Okay, so see the 3 rules are there. This is also known to you. I'm just revising it, brushing up. If the rightmost digit to be removed is more than 5, then what happened? We add 1 to the preceding number. Check the example, 1.386, okay. Suppose you have to remove the 6. 6 is more than 5, so what you'll do? You'll add 1 to the preceding number, so your value will become 1.39, okay. Your value will become 1.39 because you are removing 6, which is more than 5. Now, if it is less than 5, okay, if the value, if the number you're, if you remove, whatever you are removing is less than 5, then what happened? Nothing to be added, okay. The preceding number remains same. Suppose you have to remove this 4. 4 is less than 5, so the number will remain 4.33, nothing to be added. Now the thing is, if the number you have to remove is 5, okay, neither more than 5 nor less than 5, the number exactly is 5, then what to do is, that time you will see the preceding number, okay. If you are removing 5 and your preceding number is a odd number, that time what happened? That time you have to add 1. See here it is written. If the rightmost digit to be removed is 5, then the preceding number is not changed. If it is an even number, so if you are getting an even number, it will not change. But if it is an odd number, then you have to add 1 there. For example, if you are given 6.35, okay, you have to remove 5 and the preceding number is an odd number. So what you will do? This 3, with this 3 you have to add 1. So 3 will become 4. So your answer will be 6.4. Same way, another example, 6.25. You are removing 5, but before 5, what you have? You have an even number. To even number, nothing to be added. So your answer will be 6.2. Okay, do remember this rules. So let's solve this. Round up the following up to 3 significant figures. Okay, 3 significant figures you have to remove. So when you'll do it, you'll do stepwise. Okay, not like that you'll see just 3 significant figure and the fourth one you'll remove. Not like that. You have to remove from the right hand side one by one. So this one, if you're solving, at first what you'll do, you'll remove the 6. 6 is more than 5, so your number will become 34.22. 1 will be added to this one because you are removing 6, which is more than 5. Then see, how many significant figures are there? There are 4. So you have to remove this 2. Now this 2 is less than 5, so your value will be 34.2. Nothing to be added. Same way, I guess you can do this. So this 3, you'll take, you will pause the video and you'll note the problem and you will try it yourself. Okay, so that's all for today. Thank you.